A new quintet of dinner parties in Come Dine With Me from 5 after Deal or No Deal on 4.
£22. £250,000. Just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal. For the pilgrims. Welcome to the Dream Factory in Bristol. Start of a brand new week. Oh, what a game we had yesterday. Oh, my word. A reminder game, I think, is the way to describe it. Angie reminded us that the most difficult question on this show is not Deal or No Deal. It's another question that involves a four-letter word. It's swap or no swap. It can be the most difficult question to decide on the answer and then also to reconcile the outcome, because she had £20,000 or 1p in the last two boxes. And she had said earlier on she thought the £20,000 was on the table, but she went for the swap and actually she took £20,000 out of her life. And that's why it's so difficult to reconcile that decision, because she must have gone away thinking, if I'd just believed in the box and gone all the way to the end of the game, I would have had 20 grand, as she really wanted that money. As it is, she is the 33rd member of the 1P Club. It's a tough one, and I wouldn't rule out the banker bringing it out again. He loves seeing the pain of the swap or no swap. Here come the names. And now you are about to play a simple game that can have a simply ghastly dilemma. Martin. Yeah! Come on, Martin. It's a short walk, but it could make you very wealthy. Martin, welcome to your game. Very nice to meet you. We have Martin Gallagher from Belfast, but now living in Birmingham.
Yep.
And big job change at the beginning of this year. Tell me about that.
Changed my whole career around. I was working full-time in the care industry and body piercing.
That's quite an interesting combination, body piercing and the care industry.
Yep.
Right. How did that work for you?
Well, I worked 2 days in the care home, and then I changed and did the rest of the week in the body piercing shop in the middle of the city. Mm-hmm. So it was just a nice change of pace. Body piercing was something I always wanted to do, so I got the opportunity living in Birmingham, but it didn't pay very well, so to keep myself going, I'd work in the care home.
Right. How did you get into the body piercing?
Just through a love of it. It's mostly due to, because I'm into music, it comes with the flow, tattoos, piercings, it's just all part of it. So when I hit 18 for a birthday present, I got a couple of piercings. Ended up having over 40 done, probably.
40 piercings? Real. Must be like a colander. I mean, how do you...
Just like a wee pincushion.
Yeah.
Yeah, just put it wherever.
So, I mean, obviously earlobes.
Yeah, everywhere you can think of.
Catherine's here, your fiancé. Hello.
Yeah, hi, Noel.
Have you got any?
No. No, I'm the sensible one in the relationship.
So, what was your reaction when you first saw his
He was a lot less ornate when we first met, so I've gone with it. It's a progress over the years, so it's just part of him, and that's fine.
Right. And it's obviously the chap inside, is
yes,
the one
of
that,
course, yeah.
Yeah. Great. Huh? Now, what have you brought along here? Ah, yes, you're a very keen musician.
Yes, that's my career
and,
now.
You got some amazing qualification at drumming.
Yes.
The highest grade in Northern Ireland.
Well, I obtained the highest grade at the age of 16, being the first to do so.
Right, and you're in two bands?
Yep, in a couple of bands. That was my band back in Belfast. That stage is, well, I'd say it's quite memorable, but I can't remember it. I ended up falling off that stage, yeah.
It was that good.
It was that good.
Right then, I'm looking forward to this. I think there's all sorts of other things down here which we'll delve into. But are you happy to do battle with You Know Who?
Absolutely.
You might be able to encourage him to have a few piercings, particularly in the wallet area.
Yeah.
I need you, please, to confirm you chose box number 11 at random before all this began. It is sealed by our independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. You don't have a system, do you?
I've come up with one now.
Have you?
This is what I've gathered from since we started here, that this whole game is random. So I'm going to randomly pick boxes in the hope that they match exactly up to what I want. That's the system.
Wow.
Get it started.
We need to give it a term, don't we? Should we call it magnetic random?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Martin, good luck. I hope you have a fantastic game. Magnetic Random is born right here in Martin's game.
Looks a little bit bigger out here. Okay. Yep, let's just start with the newbie. Number 9, Pat, please.
Hello, where are you from?
Whittlesea in Cambridgeshire.
Pat, welcome to the game. Please get Martin's dream underway. Thank you. What is she doing?
It's yeah. A new technique, Noel.
Yeah, I think box Aww. Opening school for you tonight.
It just came on.
I think if you're going you freestyle, you've got to do better than that.
All right.
Actually embarrassing.
Let's get something to cheer about. Petty, we'll have you, please, number 10.
Hottie!
Hi, Noel.
Hi, Hottie.
Good luck.
You like that area, don't you? 15,000.
It's the banker's area.
Yes, you're mm-hmm. absolutely spot on there. Yeah. Nothing wrong so far. Enthusiasm, or he'll come and do random piercings.
Let's go for Fatty, number 4.
Good luck, Martin.
Cheers, Fatty.
£100,000, opening round.
Come on, mate. Come on.
The kind of piercing in the Power Five, the Benefit.
Angela, number 13.
OK. Good luck, Martin.
Cheers.
It's blue, it's blue, it's blue. Oh.
Wow. Not a single blue. 4 reds. £50,000 gone. Wow.
OK, let's go for the death box.
Oh, really? Caution yeah. to the wind.
Get rid of 13, let's get
Come
rid
on,
of
Lily, we
box.
Can't have an all red opening round.
Good luck, Matt.
We have. Extraordinary. What an extraordinary opening round. We've not had one of these for months and months and months. A heartbreaker. 50, 75, 100,000, 10 and 15. 11 blues, untouched, unblemished.
Morty, I'm up. And the big one's still there.
That.
You've got to think positive.
That is an extraordinary. Hello. That was an amazing opening round, wasn't it? Yes, he's going on about this lovely, lovely sight he can see, a whole stack of beautiful blues. Yeah, you've been looking forward to this one, have you? You like the cut of Martin's jib. Could I ask you a question, banker? Would you be so lavish with your praise if he had actually just taken out five of your lowest numbers? No, I thought not, no. Then he says, the boy Martin is a big fan of this show, so you will know to go forward in this game, you are going to need a huge amount of luck. Your box is worth 500 quid.
I'm a pretty lucky guy, Noel. Got the best fiancé in the world. Moved to Birmingham, which has just supplied me with every opportunity. And being here is one of them, so let's make it work so you can give me the question.
£500, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Good luck. Good luck.
Let's be kind to me now, please. Right, Steve, my tattooed buddy.
Martin, a top, top guy, mate. I really hope this is a blue. But get you on your way.
Yeah! Stop that, mate. Stop that. Come on.
That's the right colour. Right, Alex, number three, then.
Come on, Alex!
You and Catherine are lovely. Really lovely, and I wish you all the luck.
Yeah! Yes! That's better.
And we're on this.
There we go. We're on now.
Here it comes, a sparkling reason for the nation to return to Martin's game.
It's pretty simple. You need to go and do some business, get some tea, some biscuits. I myself have a direct line straight to the banker. It's right here.
How about that? Now that is a tattoo and a half.
Rings, you know. But because we're in the studio, it needs to be on vibrators.
TV show and the greatest game. That really is. We've had... This is Martin. I think that is an amazing commitment, Martin, because we've had people who have waited over 3 years to come on the show. We've never had anyone have the banker's phone tattooed on their leg. That's going, son. How long did that take?
Just over 2 hours.
2 hours? Mm-hmm. Splendid. Well, good luck. I hope it's going to bring you good luck.
Me too.
Yeah, at the moment, you're pretty keen to have that 1p or 50p out of here.
Yeah. Right. I go for my neighbour, Amara. Number 20, please.
Amara, need another blue, please.
Good luck, Martin. I'm going to miss you.
Yes! Yes!
Come on, are you doing?
You've got loads of blues, so you can get them out all the
Well, there's no repeat performance now of yesterday, so you just can forget about all that.
Yep, that's good to know.
We're on a...
Angie was 33, you are not going to be 34 in that little group. Excellent round. Hello. Yep, he's saying, and you latched onto this straight away. If we learnt anything from Angie's game yesterday, we learnt how important it is to find that 1p in this game. Because as long as it's sitting there, particularly right at the very end, he can do anything. Didn't offer any money at the end, just said swap or no swap. Great round. Took the 1p from £500. What a jump. £5,000.
Massive jump.
What would you spend?
Well, I've come to the frame of mind that I need a lot of money, basically, like we all do. I've got a mortgage. I'd love to, you know, pay a lot of that off. Catherine needs a new car before she starts her training contract as a solicitor, so... And also, I'd like a good bit of money just to pay her back for how much support she's given me over the last few months, because I went for a job and it all messed up and sort of became unemployed for a while. And so I changed my whole career to go and become a musician and all that. And if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have been able to do it. So I just want to say thanks as well. So we are looking a little bit higher up. So ready for the question.
£5,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
We'll go for Faye, number 19, please.
OK, oh, Faye?
Hope it's a blue Martin. Good luck.
Oh, just when we thought things had turned around.
Yeah.
Back to the first section of the game. 35,000's gone. Now that quarter mill looks very exposed.
Come on, man. OK, we'll go with Jess, number 14.
OK, Jess.
Good luck, Martin. Hope it's a blue.
Unbelievable, that is. That is extraordinary misfortune.
Still got 250 grand up there, mate. So if that's in your box, you're laughing.
I'm a wee bit off laughing just at the minute. Right. Okay then, Chris. Let's have you, number two, Chris Tavari.
Good luck, Martin. I'm really happy to play for you.
Oh, my word! Well, we've talked about the quarter million being remote and isolated, and the gap just gets bigger. We're not even at eight box, and in terms of Mega Dreams, it's all or nothing. Well, extraordinary game.
Where am I up to? I can't even count. Such a big gap.
We're up to him calling again. Yeah, actually, that was very poignant. I agree. It's not easy to work out how many boxes are gone when you've got a configuration like that. You can normally do it by counting the gaps, but there's just such a huge mess. He was saying, in a very somber voice,
I feel very sorry for the young man. He's gone to all the trouble of having the tattoo put on his leg. The way this game is going, that tattoo will be an enduring memorial to his misfortune. And that makes me very happy.
I've had the best time on Deal or No Deal, regardless of what I'm going to come out with, so you can just throw that one out the window.
It's OK, been... well, you could come out with £2,000 right now.
It has always been a one-box game for you. You've just had to admit it a little bit earlier on. So, yeah. Chin up, cheer up, go for it.
Exactly. That's it. That's the support I'm talking about?
Yep.
Yep, that's the one. Right. Let's go for the question.
£2,000, deal or no deal?
No deal.
You know, I cannot recall a game where, with so much of the game still to go, we are playing miss it. That's what it's all about. You've just got to miss it. Hello? Yeah, if he takes out the quarter of a million, he's going home with pocket change. He didn't ring just to say that, surely. OK, all right. I thought he was just playing minxy mind games with you, but he's actually pointing out, when you've got a game configured like that, as long as the quarter of a million is in there,
you will find the offers will really soar up. So keep the quarter of a million, and he's saying you'll be in five figures next time with the offer.
Right, that's what we're aiming for then. Right, darn lad, let's be having you. Number five, come on. You've been nothing but a friend, so.
It's amazing at this particular point to have so much tension and so much riding on every single box. He has no leeway. There's no flexibility in the game. We simply must not see that one. Go on, Darren.
Martin, I'm going to miss you. I'm not going to say anything nice and jinx it, but let's just hope I pierce a hole in those blues.
Yes!
You know what, Noel? Nothing ever comes easy in this world, so let's make it happen.
Go on, do it, Martin.
Debs, number 18.
Martin, you've got your life journey on your arm, so let's hope the 250,000 is right on your wrist. Good luck.
Thousand's gone.
It's gone.
Yeah, yeah. It's not even a point in groaning. This, I cannot recall a game like this. I'm not trying to over-egg it. I'm just telling it the way it is. You know, because this game is all about the quarter of a million. Because that is all he has in the game. And it will drag you back. And I bet you get your friends in and I bet you tell everyone. Come and watch this one and see whether the guy from Belfast can actually pull off a deal miracle. Because that's what it would be. Young man, Martin from Belfast, lives in Birmingham. His fiancée Catherine is here. He plays the drums, he works in a care home. He's come here with dreams and ambitions, and at the moment, every time he tries to get that dream, it slips away a little bit further. It's an extraordinary game. We're nearly at eight box, and we know that as long as you do not discover the home of the quarter of a million, at last, you're going to get into five figures. We know that. The banker has already signalled that. So this is a big box. This is a huge box in this game.
Let's go with Anne. Annie.
Number seven, here we go. Please. If it's not that one, we're in five figures.
Oh, my God.
You knew it was there?
Yeah.
Why didn't you say something?
In case it wasn't.
Bang. What an eight box. Heartbreaking game yesterday with Angie. But it was heartbreaking at the climax of the game. This one's heartbreaking. At eight box, hello. Stop it. Stop it. I thought you said you respected him. Yeah, he does respect you, but he'd just forgotten for a moment how much he loves seeing people desperately unhappy. Yes, he is as unlike you as anyone could be, yes. You look respectable, but actually you're despicable. Yeah? Yeah, Martin's good to his core. I'll go with that. What are the headlines from that? Luck is no respecter of anything. And if you'd missed it, he was going to be offering you £11,000 for 11. As it is, it's £11 for 11.
Ah, that's a no-brainer.
Going over there to Annie's box. cost you, near as damn it, 11,000.
Martin, I'm sorry. I wish I'd said I had a feeling about the box. I'm really sorry. I just, in case you don't know what's inside them, and it could have been a blue, and if I had said don't open it.
Don't worry about it. Nobody knows what's in the box.
Banker says stop trying to get out of it. You are guilty as charged. What you did was despicable.
Come on. You're all right, don't worry. Don't worry.
I'm sorry.
All right, it wasn't your fault.
Sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's okay. Let's go for the question.
£11, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
Let's open the box.
Let's open boxes. Come on, we're going to have a cheer on each one.
Yeah. All right, Chris, let's kick it off. You've been, like, such a good friend from the start. We've talked so much, so give me something low, please.
Let's get it, man.
Yes.
Come on, another two like that.
Gina, give us 21.
Thank you, Gina.
Good luck.
Yeah! You're all right. Come on, I like the rhythm of this.
Yeah, give
Box
us...
goes, hooray! Box goes, hooray! Next one.
Brian, 17.
Brian, box goes.
Martin, you're a top man.
Hooray! Yeah.
It got very easy all of a sudden. Box 12, Morley.
I think you should have done it that way to start with.
God,
well,
Morley.
You did say at the very beginning you wanted a game where random met random.
Oh, I'm on 5 bucks, sorry. Got into the swing there.
Yeah, come on, hurry up with this one. We're in the swing of things here. Yeah, don't get in the way of this. Come on. All right. He did it again there. He said, if it's any consolation, it was all Annie's fault. Little awful Annie, as he calls her. £600. £600, you've gone up from 11 to 600.
I'm gonna pay off the credit card on all the clothes I had to buy to come here.
You bought those clothes?
No.
Good Lord.
No. Yeah, OK, let's go for the question.
£600, deal or no deal?
No deal.
OK. What a game. Right, we've got the rhythm of this now. Can I just remind you, you know, there are 4 boxes here. There's only 3 of you going to be opening them at this point. Can I remind you what we do? We go, box, hooray! Box, hooray! OK.
Marley, number 12, please.
Marley, box.
Good luck, mate.
Oh!
Oh.
Oh.
Oh,
when is that back?
Here comes a big hooray.
Yeah, I know what it's going to be. Oh, where do you want to go?
Kieran, 16, yeah.
Kieran, away we go, please. Got to be 50p, then we can cheer. That's all right, yeah. Eight or one?
Eight, yeah.
Eight, all right. Come on, Paul, we're going to go about... Way! When it's 50p, thank you. Oh... Well, you can still get 500 quid. You can still actually get your first offer.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. I can't recall a game quite like this. Hello.
No. £200.
He'll buy your box for 200 quid. What do you think, Catherine?
There's no question about it. Gotta go for it.
I gotta win the big bucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've got to admire his spirit. You really have got to admire the way you're carrying yourself.
Give us the question.
£200, deal or no deal?
No deal. I got those in my box.
Oh, dear, dear, dear. Hello. Sometimes I feel like I need a good shower after talking to him. Because he was being very, very complimentary and he was just saying, when you look down at your tattoo in future, you should remember, you know, it is so important how you deal with disappointment in this life. And things don't always go your way, but it's how you deal with the knocks that really shows the character of somebody. He is offering you the opportunity of a swap and he says, if I were you, I'd take Annie's advice. He's loading everything on Annie. So, Martin, I'm empowered to ask you the question, swap or no swap?
No swap.
Thank you.
Yep.
Right.
No. Sorry to interrupt.
Yes, buddy.
Martin spent £150 to do the phone on his leg. Would the banker will be happy to offer something as he's advertising the phone?
Hello? Yes, £150. Ooh. Well, Faddy, you've created quite an interesting little end to this sorry saga in some respects. It's sorry. What the banker is saying is if I now reveal £500. Yeah, he'll make it 650 yeah, and pay for the tattoo. But if it's 50p...
Go away with nothing.
Exactly. He wants you looking at that tattoo and thinking it cost me £150 and I got nothing out of deal or no deal. So if I'm now about to reveal 50p, I'm actually revealing an empty box. But if it's £500, it's £650. Martin. I really, really hope it is the latter. Good luck. Nothing or 650? Yes! Christine, complete the game. Thank you. Give us the 50p. Right. What on earth do we say about that game?
Not much you can say. I came here with nothing. I'm leaving with something. So, yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy. I'm not ecstatic, but I'm happy.
All
I'm
right,
content.
Martin, you have carried... Oh. Yeah, you've had to come up with an extra 150 quid because of what Faddy said, yeah. Yes, he stuck up for him because he's his friend, yeah. Martin, I think the banker feels that the whole thing has backfired horribly on him because that was a great comment from Faddy, your friend, a comment that meant you got £150 and the tattoo paid for. It was just a brilliant example of friendship. And, of course, it completely scuppered the banker because he wanted you, for the rest of your life, looking down at your leg and that tattoo that you had specially done on the banker's phone, and he wanted you just thinking that you went away from deal with absolutely no money at all. As it turns out, every time you look at it, you'll remember the power of friendship. And that hacks the banker off big time.
Yeah, that's nice.
That really goes against his philosophy in life. Martin, the way you carried this off has been absolutely brilliant. And I want to say a big thank you for the commitment with the tattoo. No, I'm absolutely serious, because I believe this is the beginning of something very big. And I think you'll join us tomorrow to see who is the first player out here with the word deal shaved onto their head. See you tomorrow.
We're in Warwickshire next for a week of Come Dine With Me.